Hey fellow photographers, it's Alessandro Carpentiero and I want to welcome you to the Photography News Show, my weekly series where every Monday I bring you the best and latest news in the photography industry. Coming up today for episode number 32, we have the Nikkor Z28-75mm f2.8, a sensor from Sony that will revolutionize the market and much more. So, let's begin! Lens news. Nikon has unveiled the Nikkor Z28-75mm f2.8, its latest standard zoom lens for full-frame cameras. It's designed for those who want a bright zoom without sacrificing portability. In fact, it weighs just 1.2 pounds and is 4.7 inches long when retracted. If you pair it with the Z6II, the whole kit weighs 2.6 pounds, a bit over 1 kilogram, making it suitable for long days of shooting, whether that's an event or a day around the city. In terms of features, it's pretty straightforward. You have a zoom ring, a control ring, and that's it. The control ring can be customized to manage focus, aperture, or ISO, but I believe a dedicated focus ring is still a must-have. There are no switches, and the lens is not stabilized, so you can only rely on the in-body stabilization of your camera. The absence of these features comes with an advantage. In fact, the lens is 30% lighter than its bigger brother, the 24-70mm S, but of course it's less wide and has a less capable focus motor. The 28-75mm focal length is not new in the photography industry. In fact, Tamron has been using it successfully for quite some time. It's a range that allows you to shoot pretty much anything. Landscapes, portraits, events, street, you name it. And thanks to the constant f2.8 aperture, you get a decent amount of bokeh while increasing its usability in low-light scenarios. Talking of usability, it has some seals to prevent dust and water droplets from entry, and the minimum focusing distance is 19 centimeters, around 7.5 inches, which will allow you to shoot some close-ups as well. I see this as a first lens if you're looking for a bright zoom lens for your Nikon Z kit and you have a limited budget. In fact, it comes at $1,200, $1,000 less than the 24-70S, and you can grab it from the link in the description. While if you'd like to have a bit more versatility in terms of focal length and you don't need an f2.8 aperture, you might consider the 24-120mm f4 for a similar price. But hey, that's not all from Nikon. In fact, during the launch of the 28-75mm, it has also shared some details about an upcoming Canon, the Nikkor Z800mm f6.3 VRS. It will have a phase Fresnel lens that will make it more compact and lightweight than we think. That's all we know so far about it, so let's wait and see. Oh, and before I continue, please consider subscribing to get my weekly show and always stay on top of the industry. It won't cost you anything and you really help support my work. Thank you and let's get back to the news. Camera news. Sensors are always improving in terms of resolution and noise, but those are very tiny improvements. This week though, I have something big for you, as Sony has announced the development of the world's first stacked CMOS sensor with two-layer transistor pixels. Translated in English, this sensor will be capable of doubling the amount of light captured, greatly improving the dynamic range while reducing noise. Basically, the holy grail of sensors. It looks like truly groundbreaking news, and I'm excited to see it implemented in the future. If you want to read more details about it, you'll find the press release in the description. While if you are a Panasonic shooter that was waiting for the GH6, well, you have to wait a bit longer, as the company stated that its production has been delayed, and this is most likely connected to the chip shortage situation that I've mentioned in previous shows. Pictures of the week. In this segment, I feature the most interesting pictures I've seen on the web. Last week, I showed you a gigantic phantom jellyfish, while this week, we have another fascinating creature photographed from the depths of the sea. Specifically, a fish with a transparent head known as a barrel eye fish, or Micropinna microstoma. The images and videos have been captured by the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute with one of its underwater drones. It's quite rare to spot this fish, as it lives between 2,000 and 2,600 feet of depth, and it's only 6 inches long. If you want to know more about it, you can check out the link to the Research Institute in the description. That's it for today! I really hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Photography News Show. Which news did you like the most? Just let me know in the comments. If you've liked this video, please give it a big thumb up, subscribe to the channel, activate the notification bell, and share this video with your photography friends. And if you want to improve your mindset, productivity, and well, photography, feel free to DM me on Instagram or send me an email, and I will be always happy to help. So, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one!